taking steps towards implementation.
Dr. Isaac Mwaura is a Kenyan legislator living with albinism and also a chairperson of the Kenyan Albinism Association. He recounts the challenges that people with the same condition go through. Among these challenges is the fact that people with albinism are a prime target for ritual sacrifices.
I want to say without fear of doubt that persons with albinism have no special or magical powers. We are human beings like any other, and that given an opportunity, we too can contribute to society.
Luckily enough, the Kenyan government has changed the mentality against albinism to the extent that a special budget was put in place to cater for the needs of people living with such a disability. Mwaura appeals to the Ugandan government that a special budget be put aside to cater for the needs of the albinos as well as push for awareness.
President Yoweri Museveni, to set aside a budget to provide for free sunscreen lotions and skin cancer treatment of Ugandans with albinism. Because Ugandans with albinism do not belong to the associations, they belong to the government of Uganda.
Mwaura also concurs that there is need for tough regulations against traditional healers and witch doctors who are subjecting the albinos to ritual sacrifices.
The issue of traditional healers, it's a reality in Africa, but they need to be regulated by law. We need to know what are the qualifications, and we also need a law that outlaws such practices as use of bodies and body parts for ritual purposes.
So we need to understand who are we that we are talking about, because you might find that traditional healers play a different role from witch doctors.
In addition, Dr. Najita proposes that a special national register for the disabled be put in place to help in the advocacy for the rights of the disabled persons.
Whatever facility you have, you put reasonable accommodations so that then this person with a disability can stay in that facility, whether it is a prison.
Much as there is a witchcraft law in Uganda, this has not been enacted for several decades. Yet the traditionalists have continually infringed on the rights of the disabled through ritual sacrifices and activities. Meanwhile, the Makere School of Law has embarked on a project to train students on how best they can deal with issues pertaining to the rights of people living with disabilities so that they can ably promote awareness on different disabilities and how best they can deal with them. Rachel Nachwala for Urban TV.